Welcome and good afternoon, everyone. My name is Guadalupe Otero, and I am the ADN Assistant Program Director. It is a true honor for me to be Master of Ceremony for Guernica Academy, Fresno Campus, Associate of Science in Nursing, Pinning Ceremony, Class of 2021. I would first like to welcome our esteemed guests, faculty, family, and friends. Thank you all for joining us as we honor students' achievements and completion of the educational requirements to mark their transition into the nursing profession. The nurse pinning tradition is a symbol with a rich history dating back to the Maltese cross. The Crusaders wore the cross as a symbol of service to Christianity. Over the centuries, various symbols represented service to a ruler or to the community. By 1916, a ceremony awarding the badges was a tradition in England and in the United States. The badge symbolizes educated individuals who were prepared to serve the health needs of society. In the United States, the first pin was presented to a graduating class in Bellevue Hospital in New York City, 1880. The nursing pin and accompanying ceremony represents a purposeful experience for nursing students. It symbolizes the completion of academic educational requirements that enable nurses to sit for the state licensure examination and then practice nursing. The theme of our pinning ceremony is the importance of understanding that the art of nursing is caring. Dr. Jean Watson believes it is essential that we as nurses pause to care before any patient interaction. Center yourself on the compassion you need to provide not only your patients, but to yourself as well. Dr. Jean Watson also tells us, maybe this moment with this one patient is the very reason we're here on this earth at this time. In other words, nurses have an opportunity to make a difference one patient at a time. Since nursing is spread across all nations and translates into all cultures with the same meaning, I would like to ask our students to translate the art of nursing is caring in their own native language.
El arte de la enfermería es el querer cuidar.
Nursing di kala dekhbhal hai.
Искусство медицины – это уход за пациентом.
Итоджу энио, ниокон носин.
Thank you, students. And now to honor America, especially the brave men and women serving our nation and throughout the world, please stand and join in the singing of our national anthem.
Thank you.
Thank you. You may all be seated. It is a great honor that I introduce our honorary guest speaker this afternoon, Mrs. Caroline Perez, Chapter President of the Central Valley Chapter for the American Association of Critical Care Nurses.
Welcome and good afternoon, everyone. What an exciting day. I secretly learned of new things just as I arrived, so this is pretty exciting. What an accomplishment. It just is breathtaking. And first of all, I wanted to say congratulations. I'm so proud of you. And thank you for inviting me. I feel privileged to be here speaking to you today. It's such an honor to become a nurse. And when you're little, you know, they ask you in kindergarten, what do you want to be when you grow up? Well, I don't know. I want to be a policeman, ambulance driver. I want to work at Save Mart. I want to become a doctor. I want to become a nurse. And nursing has changed so much over the years. There have been so many opportunities that have opened up so that now, after you graduate, after you complete that NCLEX exam, you get your registered nurse license from the California Board of Registered Nursing. You have a plethora of opportunities. It's something that, you know, you can grow with. And so today is very exciting for a new adventure for you. I bring up family life, and I'm not sure if there was a program that went out, but I put a little quirky thing about me in addition to my accomplishments. And that was is when I was in my 20s, or right after high school, I said, Mom, I want to become a nurse just like you. She looked at me. I don't know if you've ever seen a mean Filipino lady. She goes, eh. And I said, Mom, I kind of was heartbroken. And she just shook her head. She said, why don't you become a dental hygienist? It's much better. And I was still like, I'm not listening to you, Mom. I'm kind of heartbroken. I think she was trying to protect me from all the challenges that nursing goes through, the heartbreak, the hard work, the sweat. But the one thing that I bring that quirky thing up is that the reason that these ladies and gentlemen are here is because they had the support of you, all of you in the audience. I want to say I'm proud of you as well for supporting these young ladies and gentlemen in their journey from nursing school. These warriors, these soldiers, student soldiers and warriors that have gone through tremendous feats that no other nursing students have gone through. So I applaud you too. I'm thankful for their friends, their families, their animals, their support persons, because it's stressful, right? It wasn't all giggles and kicks, was it? So there were stressful times. And then there were our organizations locally that said, we're so sorry. And they've gone through, there was a little heartbreak. How can I become a good nurse when I can't go at the bedside and I have virtual nurse Annie? And is Annie gonna be a real person? It's a scary time because now their responsibilities are gonna grow and their hearts are gonna grow. And along with that, as Ms. Otero said, along with Dr. Jean Watson, that compassion is a huge component of their future. So what's next? I learned that this is a combined group of graduates that some of you have already passed your NCLEX, and you have jobs. Congratulations. And so, upon learning that, I'm going to change things up a little bit. For those that you just graduated on September 3rd, what's next? You probably already scheduled for your NCLEX. You're gonna do awesome. I'm not here to give you tips because shoot, I took that like 20 years ago. All I know is just practice. And I know that you guys are smart. I know that there are excellent teachers on your campus. Some of them have even taken care of me. And you should be very proud of them because these instructors that you have are they're just prominent healthcare workers within our Central Valley. So thank you so much, instructors. Graduates, ladies and gentlemen, you have the knowledge and you already have the skills. Please don't underestimate yourself. You know this, you've got this. And I'm sure that many of you that have all graduated earlier and passed your NCLEX and have a job, you're just like, wow, that was just a breeze. Well, it was a hard breeze, Chicago. We're talking Chicago breeze. Okay, so now we have the after the NCLEX. And like I said, I'm sure that you guys felt shortchanged. Okay, now I gotta find a job. Oh, we're gonna suck you, ladies and gentlemen, in. We are so short-staffed. We're gonna love you being there. I'm gonna love being your preceptor. Have any of you guys had me as a preceptor? Okay, good, you don't have to give any feedback. So the shortchanging, you haven't been at the bedside, don't you worry. You're gonna learn so quick. It's easy to learn to care. Well, not really. It's not that easy because this is a great diverse audience. You have a great group of people, different languages. I love that. Different kinds of people that don't have the same mindset. And did you know that these people are a culture themselves? Nurses, we have our own thinking. It's like we have our own little island and we think differently. And then all of a sudden it's like somebody from the community comes in and says, what? It's a privilege to serve those people. It gives you a different perspective of the world. So we talked about after the NCLEX, you got your job and you got your job and you interviewed and they're gonna orient it to you. And that mindset that you have is your path to commitment. Don't credit me on this, but the path to commitment is with your hands, your heart, and your mind. You have the knowledge, you're gonna have the skills at hand, and you're gonna have the mind. Welcome to nursing, the world of change, constant change. Like I said, my mother was a nurse. She's been a nurse since the 1970s. And that's when they started thinking, oh, there's really sick people out there. They're on artificial lung machines, artificial kidney machines. We should put them in a regular place all together so that we can have the nurses to properly take care of them. That's the 70s. 80s, that's when we started stopping smoking in the hospital, I think. And then we started learning about 80s, 90s, like we got something else new. It was the technology revolution and the electronic health record comes out. And boy, what a whack that was to nursing, trying to look at somebody in the bed, trying to be on the computer at the same time. Then there's me, 2K, that we have new medical guidelines for something called sepsis. And we have to deal with acute respiratory distress syndrome and new things like that. And all of these changes, it's boom. When are we gonna get a vacation? When is the vacation coming? And I'm not gonna talk about now because, you know, we all know what's going on now. And so all this stacking. I know you have that path to commitment, the heart, the hands, the minds, but always remember that if the engine doesn't work, the car doesn't go. And so you need to take care of yourselves. I'm not saying schedule schedule months at a time to the Bahamas or something like that, you know, every other month, but you need to take your breaks. And you need to tell your preceptors that I need a break. You don't know it, but you are a leader now. After you get that registered nurse, that RN, you are a leader. You are a leader and you are a manager of that patient in the bed. You're a leader and the manager. You talk with the respiratory therapist, the physician, speech therapist, registered dietitian, nursing assistant, LVN, and even the visitors, and spiritual care, palliative care. You're that manager for that patient. And that's why you have the RN. And that's where your caring and compassion comes, because you'll be the voice for that patient. And never forget that you are that voice for the patient, because that patient needs you. I recently went through the mishap. When you guys finished school, I was ill. My whole family was ill. And I was out to pasture. And, you know, it's different to be a patient. For those of you that have been unfortunately admitted to the hospital, it is chaos. And as a novice nurse, it's going to be stressful. But you will have, and you should be given, the tools that you need to succeed. And if you don't, you always request. You don't have to take it upon yourself, because you have to take care of yourself first, and you have to take care of that patient. Be that patient's voice. So take care of that car engine. I'd like to leave you with something like this. And that is, clinicians at the bedside have a professional obligation to lead practice change in their institution. And that kind of like topples what I just said before. And that was by, I've taken that phrase from a physician here in the Valley who was, we always thought was just like, oh my goodness, you're stressed out, you're gonna have a heart attack, don't do that. We don't wanna work harder and we don't wanna do paperwork. But when I'm talking about clinicians at the bedside have a professional obligation to lead practice change in their institution, that is, you guys know when to say when. I need a break. I need a mental break or a physical break, because it's best for you. Your preceptors, they're going to be old nurses like me, and they're gung-ho. They've totally given up their heart to the patient and to the hospital and to the floor. And they say, no, we're going to keep going. I don't know how I could even be a nurse after 20 years. I could tell you I got achy joints, all right? So you guys, stay in shape. Take care of yourself. Drink lots of water. Kidney stones are real, and they hurt. So, like I said, I was going to end. And every week in my neighborhood, there is, oh, let me say this first. You're exceptional. You're an exceptional nurse. You're a great nurse right now. You better believe it. I'm going to give you a tip in closing to be exceeds expectations. And it's not going to happen when you get hired. But it's something that you should look forward to benefit our communities, to benefit the hospital, to benefit our work, to show what we do is great. So I have these two little old people, the husband and wife, and they walk around in our neighborhood, and they're cute with their little walkers. They walk around the church. It's probably like a mile that they walk. These two little old people, and the wife is always trailing behind, and she's just, oh, I'm coming. You know, just skipping and scoffing at the shoes. Just think. You see that person, those people every day, and unfortunately, illness happens. Illness happens, and they're in bed. Now, we know that, well, or maybe we won't know that these people walk every day, that they're healthy. It's kind of like the old people at the country clubs. They're playing tennis all the time. Oh my gosh, you're more fit than I am. In the future, and you guys are the new nurses, ladies and gentlemen, and you'll be putting this into practice. This will be your job, and this will come during your time of nursing, in your prime of nursing. want to challenge you. That man and that woman, they were walking around their blocks every day, 1 mile. And in the hospital, they were recovering, but we don't have miles for them to walk. But we do have an obligation to keep their activities going, meaning we need to get them out of bed. We need to keep them on their ADLs. We can't just let them be sick. We need to change that thinking that when you're ill, you're going to get hotel service. And we do that because we are so caring. You guys went through psychology classes, right? Dependency, codependency, enabling. We're so great at that because we care too much. But care enough and care more for your patients that they're able to recover at home. And that's my challenge to you. Remember not to take that tomorrow, or you're going to go to your manager and saying, you know what, Carolyn Perez said this. She was the president of the chapter, AACN chapter. And then if you say my name, they might know, and they're like, oh, it's Carolyn. But I want to thank you for having me here. I hope that that's an inspiration to you. And if you ever see me, say hi. And if you're going to be a critical care nurse, say, you better call me. And if you ever need anything, I will be happy to be your colleague, whether we work in the same hospital or you're in a different hospital. And once again, congratulations to you, class of 2021.
Thank you, Ms. Perez. Thank you for sharing your heart. Thank you. During this part of the ceremony, we would like to recognize some of our students. These students have gone above and beyond during their nursing program and have exceeded expectations. We will recognize these students for their outstanding academic performance, leadership, service, and exceptional clinical performance with the Florence Nightingale Award. Please help me and give a warm welcome to Ms. Alicia Davis as she distributes our awards. We would like to recognize three individuals with the Florence Nightingale Award. Congratulations to Sue Siong from ADN 4. Sue's not present with us today. Ms. Alicia Davis will accept this award on her behalf. Congratulations to Reina Saulog from ADN 5. Officer. Congratulations to Henry Rodas from ADN 8P5. These awards are given to nurses for exceptional courage and devotion to the wounded or sick. These students have shown excellence in clinical setting. These students were recognized by staff and, most importantly, provide kind and compassionate care. This is the highest international distinction as a nurse can achieve. Thank you, Sue, Reina, and Henry, for your dedication to the nursing profession. Student ambassadors help bridge the connection between the student body and administration by representing the student's voice, opinion, and interest. Student ambassadors can assist the Student Services Department in regulating, sponsoring, and coordinating on-campus school student activities. Most importantly, student ambassadors help carry the mission of Guernica Academy. We would like to recognize student ambassadors from each cohort. Congratulations to Tatum Sanchez from Tatum Sanchez. Congratulations, Tatum. Kira Fidalgo. Congratulations, Kira. Stacy Reeves. Congratulations to Jessica Freeborn from ADN 5. Congratulations, Jessica. Congratulations. And Marisol Flores from ADN AP5. Congratulations, Marisol. The Leadership Award is presented to students who have led their cohort with 9 essential qualities of nursing leadership. These qualities are emotional intelligence, integrity, critical thinking, dedication to excellence, communication skills, professional socialization, respect, mentorship, and professionalism. Please join me in congratulating Kira Fidalgo from ADN 4. Congratulations. Alejandra Ochoa from ADN 5. Congratulations. Neil Rogge from ADN AP5. Okay. Neil's not present with us today. Ms. Alicia Davis will accept this award on his behalf. We would like to publicly acknowledge the military service and sacrifices made by our veterans and their families. Student veterans, please stand. Please remain standing. Any veteran in the audience, please join us and stand. Thank you for your service to our nation. Thank you for the sacrifices you made and your willingness to serve our country. You have endured hardships and you were willing to risk your life to maintain our freedom. We thank you. Please welcome our next awardees who have been identified as our salutatorians. For ADN 4, Jessica Amaro. Jessica's not with us today. Ms. Alicia Davis will accept the award on her behalf. From ADN 5, Rania Solog. Congratulations, Raina. Good work. Good job. From ADN AP5, Maninder Chauhan. Congratulations, Minder. Great job. Please welcome our next awardees. The previous awardees have demonstrated academic excellence with the second highest GPA in their cohort. This honor is based on grade point average achieved. Thank you, Jessica, Reina, and Maninder, for your hard work. Lastly, we would like to recognize the valedictorians for the present cohorts. Our valedictorian for ADN 5 is Artem Belaski. Congratulations, Artem. Congratulations. Our valedictorian for ADN AP5, Marisol Flores. Congratulations, Marisol. Good job. It is not easy to be valedictorian or salutatorian in a nursing program, so congratulations. Marisol and Artem have earned this accomplishment by achieving the highest grade point average in their appointed cohort. Congratulations, great job. Please welcome Marisol Flores from ADN AP5 to the stage as she delivers her valedictorian speech.
Thank you. I'm honored tonight to receive this award as ADN AP5 valedictorian. I am an immigrant, a first-generation student who reached this country at age 4 and whose parents left everything they knew seeking a better future. Today, as they watch me, they are reaping what they have sowed with all their hard work, example of determination, and bravery. Receiving news of valedictorian was energizing. To be able to look back and see how hard I had worked, what I sacrificed and endured throughout this program. Without the endless support of my husband, Alberto, my children, Sofia and Marco, who inspire me every day to be a better person. My mama y papa, brothers, sisters, dearest friends and classmates, I could not be standing here today. There were tough times of doubt, many sleepless nights and tears, but nonetheless, I persevered, and I'm proud to stand before all of you alongside my class. Today, I would like to leave you with some inspiration, a quote that is special in my life, and to which I reach in tough times, from Olympic runner Yolanda Gale Devers. Keep your dreams alive. Understand, to achieve anything requires faith, belief in yourself, vision, hard work, determination, and dedication. Remember, all things are possible for those who believe. Thank you.
Thank you, Marisol. Please welcome Artem Belaski from ADN 5 to the stage as he delivers his valedictorian speech.
Good afternoon. My name is Artem Belaski, and I'm delighted to be standing here as a valedictorian of class of 2021. I'd like to say thank you to everyone for coming to share our accomplishments with us today. Big thank you to staff and faculty of Gernik Academy for making this happen, and congratulations to my fellow classmates and graduates of 2021. I'd like to give you guys a warning. I was told about my valedictorian accomplishments just 2 days ago, and if I stutter, or if this sounds like a rehearsal, I apologize. To tell you guys the truth, I'm shocked to be standing here in front of you guys today. My understanding was that a class nerd was supposed to give this commencement speech today. I thought I was the cool guy in class, but apparently I'm not. I am that nerd. My speech is going to contain a lot of names of people I'd like to thank personally. Every classmate of mine has contributed to my success and completion of this program, for which I am very thankful. Thank you to all teachers and staff for helping us through this phase of our journey and for teaching us wholeheartedly and with passion. Well, at least some of you guys. Thank you, Ms. Rayleigh, Ms. Rosado, Ms. Krause, and Ms. Cepeda for making things run smoothly in these difficult times of pandemic. Thank you for bringing the nursing mentality into the classroom and being advocates for us students, as you guys are for your patients. I'd like to thank Ms. Otera for being a communicator and a bridge between us students and school administration. Also for helping us launch our HESI exams and helping us utilize and realize the advantages Google Chrome has over its competitors, Safari and Internet Explorer. I'd like to thank Jessica Freeborn for being our ambassador and dedicating her valuable time to classmates so their voices can be heard. Huge thank you to Wally Scruggs for being our unofficial spokesperson and filling in those awkward pauses after questions to which we knew we didn't know the answers, and even Wally sometimes. Big shout out to Aaron Berry for being a class comedian and taking some stress and tension off our minds that comes with nursing school. I would also like to thank Amanda Hubert for endless supply of anecdotes and conspiracy theories. And Natalie Fontana, thank you for tailgating me 2 hours out of my 3-hour commute to school. Thanks to you, I was always early on class and on time. I can go on and on about every classmate's contribution to my success in this program, but I was given a time limit. Although I do want to recognize a few more people, my manager Jeff Posnick and supervisor Tony Rivas, who worked around my schedule to get me through this nursing program. Gerald Armstrong and Irma Brown for always covering my assignment when I was running late from clinicals, and the entire ICU staff at Kaiser Sacramento. My biggest thank you goes out to my family members that believed in me and encouraged me. To my 5 siblings, my parents, in-laws, my beautiful wife, Mariana, and my lovely 3 boys, Samuel, Jaden, and Lucas. I truly could not have done this without you guys. Your endless support and prayers kept me going. But most of all, I'd like to say thank you to Jesus Christ, who has never abandoned me and or ceased to love me, even though I have daily abandoned him. Your sacrifice on the cross is why I'm standing here today. I'd like to share a story with you guys today that made this day possible for me. As some of you guys may know, I come from a country that does not exist anymore, which is the Soviet Union. In the late 1980s, behind the Iron Curtain of socialist ruling country lived a 20-year-old girl who had a desire and ambition to become a nurse, just like we have done today. Her dreams were crushed when she entered the office of nursing program director with Stalin's and Lenin's portraits behind her. He gave her an ultimatum: to deny God or continue her education or get kicked out of the program. This 20-year-old girl was my mom. She was not able to continue her education because of her strong faith in God, for which I am very thankful. But her and my dad have made very big changes and sacrifices to make it possible for 6 of their kids to pursue the dreams and goals they couldn't. Changes like traveling 6,297 miles to a country whose culture they did not know and whose language they did not speak. I can proudly say that every one of their 6 kids is in the medical field or is pursuing it. My parents have motivated me and made this day possible for me. Dear graduates and former classmates, I'd like to address you guys if I may. When you guys want to change the world, don't wait for the change. Be the change you want to see in the world. I'd like to ask you guys to pursue tomorrow's dreams and hopes, not tomorrow, but today. Do not limit yourself. The truth is, it's not your skill, talent, or background that will make you the best in what you do, but demanding more from yourself, more than anyone can possibly expect. Do not compete with other people. Compete with yourself, and sky will be your limit. The only thing that can truly limit you is your will, determination, and your faith in what is possible. Now that we have our degrees, we will go out onto a field where we can truly make a difference and a change. Be the leaders in the world. Don't follow where there may be a path, but instead go where there is no path and make that path for others to follow. Your success is in this world is dependent upon your effort. Success is not an accident. It's hard work, perseverance, learning, studying, sacrifice, and most of all, love for what you are doing or learning to do. As Howard Schultz said, success is best when it's shared. Don't center it around yourself. Live your life to see others benefit from it. As my time before you comes to a close, I want to tell you guys, I have no doubt that you guys can and will reach your full potential in your careers and life. I'm very proud of each one of you, and congratulations, class of 2021.
The nursing pinning ceremony is symbolic, welcoming of newly graduated nurses into the profession. As each student is pinned, they would like to personally thank you for being a monumental part in their nursing school success. Our students will now be presented with their pins. Mrs. Silvia Silvano will be presenting our faculty and announcing our students this evening. Please join me in welcoming Mrs. Silvano.
Thank you, Mrs. Otero. Please help me give a warm welcome to Ms. Victoria Kraus, lead instructor who will pin the students in the ADN 4. Kiara Fidalgo, thank you to my husband for being so supportive throughout my schooling and so encouraging with all of my ambitions. Thank you to the friends I made within this cohort for being my understanding ear. And thank you to all my instructors and lead instructor, Mrs. Kraus, for advocating for us and leading us through our time in school. Ms. Stacy Reeves. Jenna Garcia, I want to thank my husband and my family for all their support during my nursing school journey. Also, I would like to thank my instructors and Guernica Academy for helping me achieve my dream of becoming a nurse. Ashley Sosa, I first off want to thank my family, my son, and my amazing fiance for the support on my journey through my nursing school. I would like to thank my class and clinical instructors for the guidance and encouragement during this time. Kyra Corpus, thank you to my family for always supporting me. Nancy Vang, thank you, Mom, Dad. You are the only words that come to my mind today. You have given me the greatest gift of all, an education. This achievement would not have been possible without your support, both emotional and financial. Thank you to my sisters for the long talks while I drove back home every time and for making sure I got home safe. I love you, Isaac and Isla. Tatum Sanchez. Lydia Zaldivia Baluga Flores. Crizelle Callos. Stephanie Frigine, I want to thank God Almighty for giving me the strength and ability to complete this nursing program, and to all my family and friends for their love and support throughout my nursing journey. Thank you, Guernica Academy, for this great opportunity you have given me. Thank you, Mrs. Kraus. Please help me give a warm welcome to Ms. Natalie Cepeda, lead instructor, who will pin the students in the 80 and 5 cohort. Rhea Kumar. I would like to thank God first and then my family and friends who have helped me throughout the program. Now I graduate my program and my new goals and achievements start in life. Thank you once again. Catherine Villanueva. Thank you so much to my dad, Raul, my mom, Tess, my husband, Bruce, family, and friends. This would not have been possible without your love, support, guidance, and help. Words cannot come close to expressing my love and gratitude. Love you all so very much. Yi Tao. To all my Vu Tao families, thank you for being my backbone when I didn't have the strength to carry on. Also for being parents to my girls when I couldn't, and Miss Cepeda, thank you for all your effort in helping us grow from baby student nursing students till now. Alejandra Ochoa, this nursing program has been one of the most challenging yet most rewarding experiences of my life by far. I want to thank my family, classmates, but most importantly, my partner, Jesus, for loving me and supporting me unconditionally through my highs and lows on this journey. Francesca Avalos, thank you to my parents, close friends, and my beautiful babies for all the love, support, and encouragement you've given me. I couldn't have made it through this program without you all. Juan Estrada, I wouldn't be here if it wasn't for my close family, my partner, and my family. Thank you, Maria, for being by my side and serving as my inspiration throughout these difficult times. Thank you, Mom, Monica, Omar Jr., and my dear friends for helping me achieve my lifelong dream. Amani Tor, thank you, Mom, Dad, and the rest of my family for being so supportive and loving throughout my nursing school journey. I also wouldn't be here without my amazing classmates and lead instructor, Ms. Cepeda. I love you all. Wally Scruggs. Zoe and Mackenzie, this journey could not have been possible without your love and support and all the sacrifice you both have made for me and the understanding that you have showed throughout this journey. You both truly make me proud and honored to be your father. Susie, thank you for the love and support and putting up with my rants after each class. You kept me grounded. Artem Balatsky, I would like to thank my wife, kids, and parents for the endless love and support. I couldn't have accomplished all of this without you. Thank you, and I love you. Natalie Fontana, I want to express my appreciation and thanks to my parents, grandparents, boyfriend, and my second family. I couldn't have achieved all of this without your love, generosity, and encouragement from the bottom of my heart. Thank you, and I love you. Jessica Freeborn. To all of my family and friends, I would not have been able to make it through this program without you. Thank you for your love and support. Karen, Alec, Dylan, and Macy, thank you for your perseverance through this process with me. We did it. Ms. Cepeda and Mrs. Krause, I am so thankful for you coming into my life. Love you both. Monica Reyes, thanks to my family and friends that helped me get through this. If it was not for you, none of this would be possible. Thanks for never giving up on me or my dreams. This is not just my accomplishment, but all of yours as well. I love you all. Leona Reyes. First and foremost, I would like to thank my family. More importantly, I would like to thank myself. I want to thank myself for believing in me and for doing all this hard work. Thanks for having no days off and for never quitting. Special thanks to my mom. This one is for you. Nalacy, I would like to thank my families and friends for encouragement and for supporting me through nursing school. Special thanks to my husband for believing in me and for being by my side through this tough journey. This is for us and our children. Targ Vang, they say it takes a village to raise a child, and if you are here to witness my pinning, know that you are part of my village. You have made a positive impact in my life. Thank you. To my dad and my brother in heaven, this is for you. Diane Pimapai, I would first and foremost like to thank God for helping me get through this nursing journey. To my husband, family, and friends and coworkers for their love and support. My girls Riley and Reagan for always motivating me. Ms. Cepeda for your guidance. We are lucky to have you as our cohort leader. Thank you all for helping me achieve my dreams. Raina Lynn Salog. I would like to thank my family, friends, boyfriend, and dog for all your love and support. I couldn't have accomplished this without you. Your support and generosity will always be remembered as I explore new goals and work toward new achievements. I love you all. Kamalpreet Kaur Sidhu. Being an immigrant, my journey in nursing school wasn't easy. Nursing school was my first time attending school in the United States. This journey was extremely challenging, but the unconditional love and support of my family, unconditional guidance and knowledge of the instructors, and unconditional help of the classmates is what helped me to achieve my dreams. I want to thank each one of you in helping me each and every possible way that you could. Without this journey, it would not have been possible. Thank you so much with all my heart. Thank you, Mrs. Cepeda. Please help me give a warm welcome to Mrs. Guadalupe Otero, lead instructor who will pin the students in ADN AP5. Marisol Flores. Thank you to my family and friends for supporting my goals. Couldn't do this without you. This is a dream. Looking back, thank you, God, for allowing me to reach it. Sophia and Marco, my children, who give me motivation to be a better person. I love you. Morgan Buteau, thank you to my family for enduring this adventure with me. I could have not have done this without you or your continued support through the endless hour of school, work, drive time, and the constant anxiety attacks. The support means the world to me, and I love you all so much. Maninder Kaur Chauhan, I am highly blessed to have such an amazing family and would not be who I am today without my family's love and support. I am thankful to all the instructors and staff for their support and guidance through the nursing program. Finally, a big thank you and congratulations to all my peers. We did it. Swastika Lal, my journey of becoming a registered nurse has finally culminated. It wasn't an easy task, but by the grace of God Almighty and through the untiring support of my teachers, colleagues, friends, and family, I have achieved it. Thank you, everyone who have been a part of this journey, and the best of luck to everyone in their future endeavors. C. Mua, I want to thank Gernick Academy for choosing me and giving me this great opportunity to advance my career, as well as all of the amazing instructors for being a great role model for me. I also want to thank my family and friends for always believing in me. Last but not least, I want to thank my biggest cheerleader, my baby. Eric Reyes, thank you, Jose, for supporting me through this journey and through the long nights and coffee-needed mornings. You saved me. Anissa Deanda, I want to thank my husband and three babies for bringing me joy in stressful moments, and my in-laws for all their help during my school and study time, and my mom for her support. Christina Stockton, I'd like to thank God and my family here. You've all been a big part of this journey. Mom, for always pushing me to go one step further. My husband and boys for keeping me sane and having faith in me. Daddy, I hope you're smiling down on me. I did it. Janet Prado. Corinne Cazeras. I would like to thank my family for supporting me on my journey and thank my grandmother, who's always been my biggest encouragement to follow my dreams. Sarah Solario. I would like to thank my husband for not giving up on me. Without your support, I would have not been able to accomplish my dream to be an RN. My children, grandchildren, family, and friends, I love you. Thank you for loving me and supporting me. ADN AP5, we did it. Sonia Higgins. I would like to thank my husband, Aaron, for supporting my dreams and making life easy for me while I complete the program. I would like to thank my mother, Aaronisha, Aaron Jr., and Alana for encouraging me and believing in me. I love you guys. Ashley Manny. I would like to thank my dad, mom, brother, and boyfriend, and other friends and families who supported me throughout this journey. This journey has not been any easy, and the support from these people really motivated me to succeed. Also, a very special thank you to my instructors. Love, Ashley. Thank you. Ashna Chandra. Amy Lacey. Thank you to my family for supporting me on my journey. Thank you to my husband for the unconditional love, and thank you to Adriana for being my biggest motivation. Henry Rolando Rodas. I would like to thank my beautiful wife for her love and encouragement, my kids for their patience and understanding. Thank you for always reminding me that I could do it. Finally, I would like to thank myself for not giving up and for believing in me. Thank you, self. Simarjeet Singh Sahota. Thank you to my family and friends for all the love and support they've given me throughout this journey and for always encouraging me to do better. I couldn't have done it without them. Christopher Covey. Thank you to my wife, Teresa, and sister, Amanda, as well as my classmates and leaders. Minjo David. Thank you to my beautiful family for the support and encouragement. I love you all. I'd like to thank my professors at Guernica Academy for their time and patience and giving me the opportunity to grow, not only as a student, but as a nurse.
Thank you to you. Thank you to our faculty and to all their supporters for being part of ceremony today. Please welcome Ms. Rachel Ledesma to the stage as she leads us into our Florence Nightingale Pledge.
The Nightingale Pledge has long been a long-standing tradition at nursing pinning ceremonies. The heart of the pledge is an adoption of the Hippocratic Oath taken by doctors. The pledge delineates the ethics that will be followed upon entering the nursing profession. Professional nursing includes the protection, promotion, and optimization of health, alleviation of suffering, and advocacy and the care of individuals, families, communities, and populations. The Nightingale Pledge encompasses the obligation to provide equal treatment and care, moral standards, nursing that promotes advocacy above obedience, and today's standards of nursing care. For those of you in the audience who have received pins and have dedicated yourself to the nursing profession, I ask that you nurture the students and impart knowledge to help them succeed. I would like to invite those of you who are nurses to stand with us together as we recite the time-honored tradition of the Nightingale Pledge. Please stand with us. I solemnly pledge myself before God and in the presence of this assembly to pass my life in purity, To practice my profession faithfully. I will abstain from whatever is deleterious and mischievous. I will not take or knowingly administer any harmful drug. I will do all in my power to maintain and elevate the standard of my profession. I will hold in confidence all personal matters committed to my keeping. With loyalty, I will endeavor to aid the physician in their work. And devote myself to the welfare of those committed to my care. Thank you. You may sit.
Thank you, Ms. Ledesma. Now we would like to share with you a video titled, Nurses Change Lives. And that changes everything. Nurses bring knowledge, resourcefulness, and deep patient experience to their work every day, improving the well-being of those in their care. Johnson & Johnson is proud to advocate for all nurses changing human health for the better.
During the Crimean War, more soldiers died from infection than in battle. Until a nurse introduced sanitary practices still in use today. When the scourge of polio hit the world, it was standard practice to strap down and immobilize patients. Until a nurse discovered that movement and physical therapy had far better results. In the 1950s, jaundice was a leading cause of infant death, until a nurse found that a few hours of sunlight could actually cure the condition. At the dawn of the AIDS epidemic, no one knew how the disease spread. So patients were kept quarantined and alone until nurses defied convention and embraced them with compassion. During the Ebola outbreak, the disease was thought by many to be too contagious to treat until a student nurse used what she had on hand. Garbage bags and duct tape to protect herself so she could care for others. And cerebral palsy robbed many patients of their ability to speak until a nurse gave them back their voices.
And I will always be grateful to her.
Today, we find ourselves in the middle of a pandemic. We're living unprecedented times in our world today. Every second of the day, nurses, as part of their healthcare team, are currently battling the war against COVID-19. We thank you for continuing to care, protect, and serve our community. Thank you. Throughout this journey, our students have shared many memories together. A slideshow has been created to share some of these memories with all of you.
Here's to the ones that we got. Cheers to the wish you were here, but you're not. Cause the drinks bring back all the memories of everything we've been through. Toast to the ones here today. Toast
to the ones that we lost on the way. Cause the drinks bring back all the memories, and the memories bring back your. There's a time that I remember when I did not know no pain, when I believed in forever and everything would stay the same. Now my heart feels like December when somebody say your name. Cause I can't reach out to call you, but I know I will one day, hey. Everybody hurts sometimes, everybody hurts someday, hey, hey. But everything gon' be alright, gon' raise a glass and say, hey. Here's to the ones that we got. Cheers to the wish you were here, but you're not. Cause the dreams bring back all the memories of everything we've been through. Toast to the ones here today. Toast to the ones that we lost on the way. Cause the drinks bring back all the memories, and the memories bring back your. Memories bring back your. There's a time that I remember when I never felt so lost, and I felt all of the hatred was too powerful to stop. Now my heart feel like an ember, and it's lighting up the dark. I'll carry these torches for ya, and you know I'll never drop, yeah. Everybody hurts sometimes, everybody hurts someday, yeah, yeah. But everything gon' be alright, gon' raise a glass and say, hey. Here's to the ones that we got, to the wish you were here, but you're not. Cause the drinks bring back all the memories of everything we've been through. Toast to the ones here today. Toast to the ones that we lost on the way. Cause the drinks bring back all the memories, and the memories bring back your.
Thank you to our student services manager, Mrs. Manley, and her team for the beautiful slideshow. Thank you. Our ceremony is now coming to a closing. It is my pleasure to give a closing statement. I would like to give a special thank you to our ADN program director, Dean of Nursing, Mrs. Samantha Mendoza Sanchez. Thank you for all your mentoring, support, understanding, trust, and guidance to the ADN team. Thank you to our Chief Academic Officer, Dr. Larissa, for birthing into fruition Gurnick Academy, Fresno Campus. I would also like to thank Karen Hobson, our Campus Director, Rick Ergo, Assistant Campus Director, and everyone who was part of planning for today's event. We would also like to thank our guest speaker, Mrs. Caroline Perez. Thank you for your support, for supporting our future nurses, and thank you for your service as a chapter president of the Central Valley chapter for the AACN. Thank you again, Mrs. Manley, and your team for planning our planning ceremony. I would also like to express my deepest appreciation to our ADN faculty, coordinators, managers, who continue to support, teach, guide, test, advise, and evaluate our students. Without your commitment, this would not be possible. Thank you for your excellent teamwork approach to our daily schedules. To our future registered nurses, thank you for teaching us. Yes, you teach us too, okay? You teach us compassion, kindness, humility, gentleness, patience, forgiveness, unity, peace, thankfulness, wisdom, and gratitude. Each of you have displayed these qualities in your own way. We are privileged and honored to have witnessed your perseverance, your resilience, and your sacrifice. Your committed dedication to your studies while in the middle of a pandemic is heroic. Thank you for trusting the process and running your most challenging race. We are so proud of each and every one of you. Thank you to all the families who supported your student in any way. Lastly, students, deliver your nursing practice with compassion, like Mrs. Perez talked about. Knowledge and your nursing priorities, using wisdom, integrity, and never get tired of doing the right thing, even when no one's watching. Advocate for your patients, and please take care of yourselves, your family, and your community. Congratulations, and thank you, everyone, for joining us today. This concludes the ceremony. Congratulations.